Macau feels a lot more internationalized. The quality of the people has gone up. It feels that education standards are much higher as well, and that there's a lot more mobility. And in terms of tourism, I think they've really, really stepped up their game. It's a nice weekend getaway for me from Hong Kong, from the hustle and bustle of Hong Kong. But at the same time, you know, I love the variety, I love the internationalization that Macau has become since the handover. Mm-hmm. And in addition to that, you know, the food's great, people are friendly, and the facilities are amazing. So you really couldn't ask for more. Like Hong Kong, it's also a very good gateway for the UK to export a lot of its culture and trade. I work more in the space of education, and it does come across that there are a lot more opportunities around education, especially exporting a lot of the UK's you know, educational assets over. When we talk to people who are keen to come from the UK to Hong Kong and China, Macau is also on the list nowadays. In terms of influencing, it'd be interesting to see how, you know, as a hub, how they can basically broaden their offer to the rest of the Greater Bay Area and influence and inspire, you know, different initiatives, you know, that they've done very well here and that they've led on. It does seem like there are a lot more opportunities, and we are a lot more keen to basically establishing ourselves in Macau, because I think the links are there, and it's just one of those things where in the past, for one reason or another, we never really got a chance to explore and really understand the needs of Macau. And now they're becoming a lot more clear, particularly in terms of how it's related to, you know, the Greater Bay Area.